Crazy here with Lewis, who is 5 years old today. Happy birthday to you, Lewis, from Mummy and Daddy, Callum and Fraser, and Lydia, and all of your friends and family.
Have a great day. Keep sending those birthday cards in to us here at the usual CBeebies address. And if it's your birthday today,
happy birthday!
Hello, welcome to number 22. I'm Thomas Ticker. I seem to have made a bit of a mess today. I can't find my glasses. I know I had them recently, but I can't remember where I put them. Oh well, never mind. The wonderful celebration I've got for you today is called Norouz. Norouz marks the first day of spring and the beginning of the year in the Iranian calendar. It's celebrated by Zoroastrians, and I've got two friends who want to tell you all about it.
I'm Marvin.
And I'm Vinifa.
And together we are getting ready for a special celebration called Norouz.
We are Parsi Zoroastrians. Norouz means new day in Persian. It celebrates the first day of our new year and the first day of spring.
Off you go and clean your rooms then, quickly.
I don't usually like time out my bedroom, but we're getting ready for Norouz and I just don't mind.
It is very important to start the new year very clean and tidy. So we are helping our mum to give the house a good spring clean.
Dusty, dusty, dusty.
Now it's time to make my bed.
Finish cleaning. We have to go to Zoroastrian house.
Okay.
Let's go. I'm so excited to see my friend.
It's time to go and see our friend at the Zoroastrian centre now. This is where we come to celebrate Norouz in a couple of weeks. First thing that we're going to do is go up and pray with our friends.
Come on.
There are three things that we must do before we go inside. We must take off our shoes. We must wash our hands. And we must cover our heads.
We're going up to the prayer room now. We are saying a special prayer.
Okay, now everybody bow down.
We're putting a special ash on our foreheads. This is a special blessing.
Well done.
Spring is a time when nature comes alive. Flowers and trees blossom. So one of the things we do to celebrate this is by growing wheat or lentil seeds.
We are making special things to go on a table, and it's called the hashing table. First, we're going to plant lentil seeds that will grow into a plant. Then we'll put that on the table.
We plant the seeds 2 weeks before Norouz.
These seeds have been soaking in water for 2 days to bring them to life. Then we take these pieces of cloth and make them all wet in the water.
Then we cover up the seeds with the wet cloth. There, my seeds are planted.
I'm so excited by Norouz. My plant might be this big.
We are now going to paint and decorate some eggs to put on the hashing table now.
I'm going to paint a rainbow, a butterfly and a flower on my egg.
When we see the eggs on the hatching table, they help us to remember nature and life all around us.
I can't wait to see what my mum thinks when my egg is on the hatching table.
Look at my pink butterfly.
My egg is really messy and colourful.
My egg's finished.
There we are, all done.
See you soon for our Norouz celebrations.
Ooh, that all looked very messy. But my house isn't messy anymore. Ta-da! I copied Berzin and Benifer and tidied my room. Well, when I say tidy, I mean I put everything here on the table and it's... I suppose I'd better tidy up properly. But while I do this, there's a great story that is heard at Norouz. Celebrate!
One day, a kind shepherd called Jamshid was herding his flock when God called to him and said, "Jamshid, beware. Soon evil will send a really long winter and a heavy snowstorm that will kill all the people, animals, birds and plants in the world. I need you to help me." When Jamshid heard God's plan, he found a large cave and searched far and wide for people to take inside. He found animals of every kind and gathered plants and seeds, putting them in large sacks, and took everything to the cave where he lit a fire and waited. The following day, dark clouds appeared in the sky and covered the sun. Soon snow began to fall. It snowed and snowed until everywhere, mountains, forests, and even deserts were covered with snow. But for 40 months, Jamshid, the people, and the animals were all warm and safe inside the cave. Then, one morning, Jamshid took one of the white doves and let it out of the cave. It flew around, but finding nowhere to land, returned to the cave. A few days later, the dove was released again, but once more there was nowhere for the dove to land. A few more days passed, and this time, when Jamshid released the dove, it didn't come back. The snow had melted. Everyone slowly emerged from the cave. Jamshid and the people gave thanks to God for helping them survive the harsh winter. The new day, or Norouz, had arrived. And that's why Zoroastrians call it Jamshidi Norouz to this very day. It's great
to celebrate! Isn't that a great story? Imagine it snowing for months and months and months. You forget what colour the grass was. Well, I've tidied up now. Still haven't found my glasses. But I did find these sticks of chalk. And I've got a bit arty and drawn a message for Berzin. Happy New Year! And Berzin is using chalks to make some special patterns for Norouz. Shall we see?
Happy Norouz!
On the morning of Norouz, we put chalk outside.
This chalk will bring us lots of good luck for the new year.
That's it.
I'm putting purple chalk onto the flowers.
That's it.
Our patterns are really colourful.
This helps me. Flowers help me.
One, two, three.
Okay, next one.
I'm putting orange on it. This says Happy New Year because it's our new year today.
My pattern's finished.
Well done, you two.
Mummy's going to get our new clothes. I'm so excited.
Not only is it important to have a nice, clean house for Norouz, it's also tradition to wear new clothes.
Look at my new top and my new trousers. I'm going to look very smart in this.
Look at my new dress.
Do you remember the wheat seeds that we planted the other day? Well, look how much they've grown. I'm going to take my planter pot on the hatching table later on.
We've arrived at Granny and Granddad's house. My granny is putting a mark on our foreheads. This is called a tele. My granny is putting a garland around our necks.
There's your little Prezi.
Thank you.
A happy Norouz.
Happy Norouz, Granny.
Thank you.
And Norouz Mubarak.
Thank you.
Watching the hushing table being laid.
Lots of special items are being put on this table. Lots of them are to do with nature, and they make us remember life all around us.
And our plants are going to be put on too.
Look, there's a picture of a fish. It makes us think about animals.
The nuts make us thankful for the food we eat.
Our painted eggs are going to be put onto the hushing table.
Mummy!
Mummy! Look at how many of our eggs on the hushing table!
Wow!
And our plants.
Which one is yours?
This one's mine.
Wow!
And this one's mine.
Your plants. Well done. It has grown, hasn't it? Looks lovely. Well done.
Yeah, before our celebrations begin, we've got to go and say our prayers in the fire temple. The fire burns in that big urn all the time. It reminds us of God's light.
Can you see the priest putting the sandalwood on the fire?
The Zoroastrian priests wearing special white clothes.
Now it's time to join everyone else for a big prayer ceremony called a jashan. It's where they say thank you for lots of things.
I've been given a very special job to give the priest some sandalwood. There is a lot of people around for the celebration now. Look at their new outfits. I love playing with my friends.
The food is yummy.
We are having so much fun.
It's great to celebrate! Yeah!
It's great to celebrate!
Thanks, Brzin. I really enjoyed that. Oh, I still haven't found my glasses. Here they are. Have they been here the whole time? Why didn't you tell me, Sprocket? Oh, well, now, where can I put them? Ah, I'll put them up here so I won't forget them. Now it's time to go outside for my own street party. Hey, hey!
Can't wait to celebrate, it's great to celebrate. Can't wait to celebrate, it's great to celebrate. Can't wait to celebrate, it's great to celebrate. Can't wait to celebrate, it's great to celebrate.
That was very interesting, and it has reminded me of how much fun it is to celebrate different things. Look out for another fun festival next time on Let's Celebrate here on the CBeebies.
Beebs.
What's that, Beebs? There's a special report coming in from Sunny Sands. Oh, yes. Hello, Jason. Can you hear me, Jason?
Hello, Sid.
This is Jason Mason, reporting from Sunny Sands, and today I'm in my dad's bike shop. And here's Mr. Like a Biker.
Hello, Jason. Hello. Yeah.
So, Mr. Like a Biker, what do you like best about Sunny Sands?
Oh, Jason, well, I like a town with a decent bike shop.
Yes.
Oh, and I like a bike shop with loads of bikes.
Yes.
Oh, and I like a bike with a dingly bell.
Yes.
Oh, and I...